buddy, Lawman Mike with www.lawmanguitars.com. Boy, have you ever seen one of these? I've seen several of them, and this is the one that you want to find if you're looking for one that's not an Epiphone. This is the pre-lawsuit 1974 Ibanez Howard Roberts Jazz Guitar. Now, these were made to replicate the Gibson and Epiphone Howard Roberts guitars that were out at the time, and of course they were copying them really, really, really well, as you can tell from looking at it. I mean, this is an absolutely beautiful, beautiful guitar, and I have never played the Epiphone, but it's hard to imagine that it would play or sound just as nice as this. This is just an incredible instrument. We put flat wounds on it. It came to us with flat wounds. Jazz guy had it and would understand why he had flat wounds on it. This guitar just sounds great. I mean, it's designed to be played jazz, although you will see you can play anything on it. But the way it was designed with the neck pickup floating attached to the neck, it's not actually attached to the guitar, it's floating, is very much a jazz guitar application. Now, this guitar was made in the Fujigen factory in Japan, and they put a what's called an antique violin finish on this beautiful, beautiful flamey maple top. I mean, this guitar is just absolutely gorgeous. You can see that the arch top here is just very, very pronounced right here by the sound hole. I can feel it just as I work my hands up and around it, and it just helps this whole sound of this guitar just. It just rolls out of this guitar. It's just fantastic. Now, from there, the pickup is original. The tuners are not. I noticed that the tuners are some very nice perloid buttons on those, and it looks like they're either Ping or, gosh, even, no, those are not Ovation, but they have an Ovation-looking body on. I think those might be Ping tuners, very high-quality tuners that they replaced on here. And the bridge, I don't believe, is original. It looks too new. But other than that, original pickguard, which a lot of times these will have gassed off, which from the nitro cellulose fumes that come off of your finish, it reacts with plastics, and sometimes these things will gas off and they deteriorate. This one did not, so it was not spent all of its time in its case. Original knobs, original tailpiece, just beautiful, beautiful frets on this guitar. Original frets, and from having flat wounds on it all its life, they are still in great shape. And it's got, of course, the open book headstock from Ibanez, which helps us identify it as a 74, as well as the flower pot, which replicates the Gibson or Epiphone flower pot they used on their guitars, in that clever how they did that, to look almost exactly like Gibson's. From there, I mean, it's just, what an incredible guitar. Look at this back. I mean, my goodness. Book matched back, again, flamey maple. Just this finish, I can't help keeping my hands off of it. It feels so nice. Great Florentine cutaway, which I love Florentine cutaways. Florentine means it comes to a point here as opposed to a rounded cutaway, which a lot of Gibson guitars have. This is a Florentine. The Birdland would have had a Florentine, just to give you another point of reference. And it's a wider body. It's more of a jazz body. I think it's 3.5, if I remember correctly. It has a 24 3/4 inch scale neck, a 1 11/16 nut, so it's going to feel very, very familiar to you as you play it. And then gosh, what a sound. Thank you. What a sound. The other thing I like about this guitar, it has a tone pot down here to give us somewhat of a varietone, which is a really cool feature. Brightened it way up and really brought a different sound completely out of this guitar. Just a little bit and just get a whole bunch of different sounds. Well, that's very mid-rangey right there. Trick pony guitar at all. I'll tell you what, you can play just about anything on it. A great guitar. We did not get the original case with it, and I'm not even sure that you'd want the original case. The made in Japan cases for these jazz boxes are a lot like their thin-bodied Les Paul style cases. They're original cases, and I wouldn't say I wouldn't want to have the case with it. It's not nearly as nice as what the case is you'd want to travel with that guitar in, which is what we've got. We got it without a case. So I searched far and wide and found this gorgeous case. I can't even remember where I got it now. It was not new, although I think it was a little shop-worn when I got it. But it's arched like the guitar. It's a Glary case. I've never heard of Glary cases, but I'll tell you, it is one high-quality case. Got her case key and everything, padded handle. Inside, it's got black interior and accessory box. And I'll tell you, it fits that guitar absolutely perfect. When you put that guitar in there, there's no movement whatsoever. Now I'll tell you, and especially for those of you who might be shipping guitars, what hurts guitars as much as anything is a guitar banging around inside your guitar case. You want a case that fits it very tightly. If it doesn't, you need to pack newspapers and stuff around to make sure they don't bang around in there, or it can hurt themselves as much inside the case as banging around inside the box, okay? So you want a fine-fitting case for a guitar like that. This one fits it like a glove. So I love this case for that guitar. If it wasn't original, I'd want this case. So check this and all of our really, really, really cool guitars out that we have for you this month. 1974 pre-lawsuit Ibanez. I know there's some other ones out there that don't have the Ibanez logo. Ibanez made them and they put some different names on them for different shops. You want the one that says Ibanez on it. That's the finest one of those Japanese lawsuit guitars that they made, and that's the one. Tell you what, that's the best one I have ever touched. Check it and all of our great guitars out at www.lawmanguitars.com, where we only sell really cool guitars. And thanks a lot for watching my demos. I really appreciate it.